I've got to like deal with. Is that where your life comes? It doesn't matter if you're actually and attention towards, or if it's any, it's painful because nobody talk fit in with everyone else. Well, self-esteem and whatnot. Self-esteem and whatnot. Self-esteem and whatnot. Hello YouTube, and welcome back to another Raging Reality reaction video, and welcome to pretty much a little segment I like to call Life is Sweet, so they say. Because, ladies and gentlemen, in memory of Steve Priest, who recently passed away from the suite, I thought it would be a bit of a nice change of pace, well, considering, you know, RageCon and all that, to literally just, like, listen to a couple of the songs by the suite over the next couple of videos. I'm just literally going to pull some of these videos completely at random, and just to see what we can get out of it, because I think Steve would have liked that. At least, I hoped he would have liked that. Well, again, you tell me what you think he would have liked, and we'll see where it takes from there. So, if you guys want to check out the original video for yourselves, links will all be in the description down below. Let's begin. Identity crisis in 3, 2, 1, and... turn this up and take it back 10 seconds. I love that part of dun 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 dun. I love that part they're doing.
Identity crisis. I'm going through my identity crisis.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, that was Identity Crisis by The Sweet. Damn, man, I've forgotten how much I friggin' got into that. Mind you, now can I just make up an interesting point before we go any further into this? I know fine well that there are, like, it's, I remember when Michael Jackson died back in 2009, and I remembered over the next couple of weeks, a lot of his big hits went really, really high in the top 10 in the UK. Some things like Man in the Mirror, Thriller, Billie Jean were all in there for weeks. Why there weren't, probably like maybe like the teens, they were a little bit higher. There were other stuff as well, like The Way You Make Me Feel, I Just Can't Stop It, Loving You, Smooth Criminal, all that sort of stuff. Has there ever been a point, and maybe it's just because I don't follow like rock top tens and all that, because I would love to straight up know how tight-knit that sort of community is, because I would imagine like it would be friggin' criminal to at least not like remotely kind of like mention The Sweet, because they deserve sort of like that spot for people to remember that some of the stuff they came up with was really, really popular. And it's because, oh, even if they're over like 40 years old, you know what? Who cares if they're over 40 years old? Some of the stuff is absolutely divine. And Identity Crisis, maybe because, I don't know, I definitely feels like this might possibly be the best I've heard from them. Not just in terms of the music, because I love the dun 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 dun. It was really catchy. That's something I've just like caught on from The Sweet, is that a lot of their stuff is really, really catchy. And, well, sometimes in a song, that's really all you need. Sometimes if you have a good enough beat, if you've got good rhythm, and, you know, people catch on to that, and they'll think that's pretty, pretty enjoyable, because, well, why not, I suppose. Then, however, when it comes to some of the lyrics we just covered, I absolutely got behind what The Sweet are trying to do, where... It's a good game when you're winning. I particularly like that. Like, who really enjoys coming in last place in a game? Well, nobody, because you're losing. You've got pretty much nothing to win for. It's a bit like, I mean, I'm just going to take you through one example. There's this British game show called Tipping Point, in which basically to get to the final round, you've got to be in the lead with the most amount of money, and the person with the least amount of money at the end of each round goes home with nothing. But what's really good about that is that... I'll just go through this in a second here. Just there's an email come up that I've got to like deal with. In fact, I'd probably be better if like I take this off as well, because I can't really like... really leak any information, I should say. So anyway, what I was trying to say was that you've got to, forcibly, you've got to be in the lead. It's not really one of those games you could like it. And that's the really dickless thing about money in the real world, because it's either you win hundreds of thousands, you either win or you go away with absolutely nothing. There's almost nothing in between, is there? And when you become so obsessed with money, or you become actually borderline obsessed with anything, it really is like going through an identity crisis, because what on earth do you do? Who is this really the person you've now become? Is this literally just your life, that all you can think about now is just thinking about where the next penny is coming from and just literally clawing at with your own hands? Is that what your life comes to? And then Everybody Loves a Star, makes no difference who you are. I guess it's true when I say sometimes gravity revolves around dense objects. In fact, what's quite ironic about that is that they say star, but it doesn't matter if you're actually very well talented, it doesn't matter if you're very well spoken, very well educated, it doesn't matter if you're complete trash and you're literally just a laughing stock for the whole world. As long as people are paying attention to you, your star will grow brighter until it completely like dominates everything else in the solar system. And again, the amount of light is just given to how many people pay attention to it. I won't not going to list any examples right now, but think about people you hear about in the news over and over and over again. Do you consider them stars? Well, a lot of people pay attention to them, and like they said, it makes no difference who you are, because if you're being paid attention towards, or if it's anybody you know that is gaining a lot of like popularity through whatever it is they're deciding to do, politicians, musicians, you know, TV personalities or whatnot, it's painful, because you're wondering what exactly did they do in the first place to get so popular. And then that's another example really of an identity crisis, because what do you want? And you're looking at all these people, you're just sort of like going, well, you know what, I could do that, I could be successful, I can be exactly like them. And then what happens if it doesn't come through? And then you go through another identity crisis, because do people really have that low an opinion of themselves, or do they have that little self-esteem that they've always got to change their outlook just so they can fit in with the norm? But once you fit in with the quote-unquote norm, nobody talks about you. You're just like everyone else. You're absolutely the same. So trying to change who you are into something you're not won't gain attention. Trying to change back and fit in with everyone else won't get people's attention. And then it's a real problem. And for people who don't think much of themselves, like low self-esteem and whatnot, you got to think about what could be going through their minds right now when they think to themselves, you know what, I set myself out to be this person, and all of a sudden I'm just looking at myself in the mirror at this point. It's disparaging a lot, and I can say right now, I've not really gone through that sort of problem myself. I've gone through problems where I feel like I deserve a whole lot more than what I'm given. But you know what? I feel like everyone is kind of like that. Everyone always feels as like they should get more for what they're trying to. They say that in life, you get out of life as much as you put into it. But is that technically true? Because I can think of far more people right now who are far more talented and do far more exceptionally great work than what I'm doing right now. And they're worse off than I am. And you got to think about, well, where's the justice in that? What are they doing that they can't gain that sort of like a following, I should say? And the race is never won until it's over out in the cold. It's only over when you just decide, you know, call it quits. And I think that last part here is really, really like that sticks out in the cold. Like you've just been thrown out on the street, and the only people who are not out in the street or in the warmth, surrounded by everybody, all of a sudden you're irrelevant and nobody will pay attention to you, because there will come a time where people will just either become so bored they will just throw you out. Even if you've literally reached the top of the mountain, there is that old saying that nobody stays on top forever, and all of a sudden you're gone, and somebody else will climb the same mountain, but they'll bring a ladder so they can say they're higher up than you are. Money helps to pass the time, but it won't buy peace of mind. So much more to light the fire burning inside. I was going to make a remark about money burning a hole in your pocket, but it's burning a hole inside your mind, like saying, what on earth am I supposed to do? What have I got to do? Money isn't going to, you know, buy what I just had back. And all of a sudden, you feel as if like you're just going up in flames. What you've earned is absolutely not what you wanted. And then you look yourself in the mirror again, saying that, you know what, is that it? Is my identity literally just someone for people to throw money at? Like some higher class stripper? Is that all I'm worth to some people? Just throw your money at and I'll literally bend over if you want me to. Jesus, that's... And I don't know whether I'm just literally looking at this way, way too hard, but I don't know, guys. I friggin' got A-levels in friggin' English literature. I can't help but look through pieces of text like this with that sort of, like, an air of cynicism. But you know what? I feel like there's a lot of weight to it. I cannot help if to give the impression that this is what the suite were trying to convey, because you know what? What else am I supposed to think? Because, again, even in pop music, right? In fact, I'll end this video off in a very strange way. And it's not just pop music as well. Because think about stuff in pop music, whether you really, really, you know, I would say successful people, because they get the most money, they gain all the press, they gain all the stories and all that. But it could be just the same for, you know, rock musicians, rap artists, hip hop stars, all that. Any success can go to literally anybody in this world. And you know what? Anybody has a chance to succeed. Even fools. Fools who have exceptionally small minds and think that one day they are just living in fear for the one day when their success is literally going to come tumbling down, when somebody will climb that mountain, like I mentioned earlier, and then bring a ladder. And I literally just looked up pop music that talks about identity, and it doesn't really seem to be given much out here. I mean, I suppose really I could look about pop music that talks about like social issues and that, but it doesn't really seem to be. They've just given me a load of lists of books here about semantics in popular music and digital contexts on popular music and its unruly entanglements. Actually, that looks pretty cool, but nearly 90 euros for a book. I mean, I like reading, but is it really that justified for a book like that? I mean, hell, I paid £12 for my Screenwriter's Bible, the third edition that comes with stuff about, it comes with stuff like about copyright, about law infringements and all that within the world of Hollywood, but listen, guys, I'm not in any way what you might call like a psychiatrist or anything. If you only want to go and talk to somebody about like the dangers of literally like popularity and questioning who you are, you might want to go seek someone else a little bit more qualified than that. But I think it says something about the suite where I feel like they've nailed Hollywood almost entirely in just under 5 minutes. Or success for that matter, in any case. Money helps to pass the time, but it won't buy peace of mind. So light the fire that's burning inside. What gentlemen, eh? What absolute gentlemen. So anyway, I hope you guys have enjoyed this reaction video. Please leave your thoughts and comments in the comment section down below. Let me know what you guys thought of Identity Crisis by The Suite. Please also make sure to also like and subscribe to get daily notifications when my videos come out. And I hope to love you guys again in the next reaction video. Take care, and good night, sweet priest.